Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. We're back with the Music Theory series, but this time I just got done filming the new course called Music Theory in under 10 minutes. And every video is literally under 10 minutes, going over the core things you have to learn about music theory for modern beat making, not just like classical music theory or jazz theory or all these interesting things about theory, but we don't really use it for modern music. That almost rhymed. So today I'm going to show you a cool technique that I kind of discovered in a new way making this course. And this is how to make your chords sound more exotic, doing something really simple. So here's something that we created. So the sound selection is Hermes. Under Dark Trap, this is our new expansion for Hermes. Under Bells and Trees, that's the bell sound. And then the piano's from Keyscape, called the Grand Piano. Okay, so here's what we did. So basically, if you just copy these notes, and we're gonna start from scratch, so don't worry, we're gonna start from scratch. I'm just showing you what I did. So what we did was we took some chords, I inverted a couple notes, and then what I did was I took half of the chord, put it on one instrument, then the other half on the other instrument. So it created this really unique chord stacking. I call it chord voicing. But it created a really unique sound that you just can't get by just playing chords on one instrument. So let's start from scratch. I know that sounds kind of, you know, whatever, but it sounds good to me. And we also purposely detuned this sound too, by the way. Okay, so the question is, how do you start from scratch? So let's go to pattern 5 and let's start from scratch. So I'm going to start with more lush chords in this case, like a ninth chord. There's a chord code book you get with the whole new course, but I'll just kind of quickly show you the FL Studio shortcut. If you go to stamps, a minor 9, let's just start with a D minor 9. Oh, wrong pattern. So let's start here. So firstly, we have to create a chord progression. So let's create that. And I want to go one octave lower. Now for the video's sake, I'm not going to get too crazy about all the different chord types and getting into the science. We go through that in the course. We go through how to literally start from scratch and make a chord progression. We go through intervals, we go through modes, scales, keys, key modulation. We go through how to make melodies from scratch, how to end your melodies, how to stack your melodies to sound really full. There's a lot in there. So, you know, I'm gonna save you some of that time here because there's a lot to explain. Okay, so let's just use two chords for now, and then we'll do like a little turnaround chord at the end, called a diminished chord. Okay, so you don't have to know all this, I'm just letting you know why I'm doing what I'm doing. Okay, so it sounds jazzy. Okay, so let's, you know, add a little spice to it. I go through this in the course, but there are shortcuts you can use to make your chords sound a little more exciting. And once you do these shortcuts, you'll be able to, you know, make it sound more realistic as well. It just sounds more human and it sounds more alive instead of just like slamming on the keys. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is making sure the notes don't overlap, because in FL Studio, if they overlap, it mutes the note. And I'll chop off the end notes here. So now that we have that, so what I did in the video was I took two notes at the top, left them on the piano. Every other note went to my plugin called Hermes that just came out with new expansions. So let's hit Control Shift and highlight these multiple notes. So again, I'm only leaving the top two notes for the piano. Hit Control X, and then remember we started at D just in case we lose our spot. Then go over to Hermes, paste. And then we're at the note D. So in Hermes, I pulled up the preset called, it's under the Dark Trap expansion. It's called Bells Trees. It has a really unique sound. I just pulled up the spread and then I turned up detune a little bit. Let's set it back to normal just so you hear where we started from. Okay. So now when you combine these two, and also what I did was, I forgot to do inversions, but I pulled the notes up one octave for the Hermes. So now your ear is hearing a whole chord, but it's across two different instruments. So it sounds, your ear like pieces those two together as if it's one. And that's a simple thing you could do to make your chord sound a lot more interesting without even having to add all this jazz theory. It's just splitting up notes. Okay, so what I did to make it more customized is use some of our built-in effects like the detune. I purposely pitched it up. Then I used our spread knob just to add more animation to the sound. And now you have like a full enveloping type of sound. Now if you want to get really, really fancy, you can invert notes. And so here's where you can kind of dig into the complexity of it. So let's say you want to take all the bottom notes and pull them up one octave. You can hit Control Up. So that gives you like a, okay, so let's say you wanted to spice it up. You can copy the notes over and you don't even have to change the chords. You can literally just take the bottom notes here, hit Control Up, pull them up into a different octave. And you could do the same or just keep the same chords in the top portion. And where do we start? Is this C? So again, remember these are the top notes of the chord. So you could take that top note and pull it down an octave, or you don't have to. Let's just see what it sounds like. So if you don't see these little grayed out notes, go to your piano roll options, go to helpers and go to ghost channels. And I'm going to change mine back to the black notes. There we go. My scale highlighting. It sounds interesting. I would probably change the timing of the piano. Okay, so you get a really unique sound to this piano, something that you just could not do with one instrument. Even if you switched up all the voicing, you can't get that just by using the one instrument. So it expands it beyond just voicing. It expands it into however many layers of different sounds you want to add. Now let's try to add one more layer. This may be overkill, but let's try one more layer. And if it's overkill, I'm not going to force it. Well, let's go to dark trap. Let's go to bells. The reason I have so many bells is because you could stack a lot of bells without conflict. I like bells and pads mostly. Let's see. Tree, woods. So this is a high pitch of bell. It's okay. And then let's take maybe the bottom note of the Hermes notes. Let's take this. I'm hitting Control Shift and left click to highlight. Hit Control X to cut. Go into the piano roll of the new instrument. Hit Control V to paste. So now we have three instruments. Now again, this may or may not sound dope. Oh, this is, let's turn this down. This way everything works together and it just sounds like one cohesive element. With a little reverb. And this way you can customize each sound as well. So this is how you can uniquely, like let's say you had a synth that was wide for the top notes and then the second layer was like low mids but mono and then very saturated, and then the low notes could be like low pass filtered. So you can create textures per the notes of the chords, and that's where you get into the deep complexity. Let's pitch this up a little bit. Okay, so it just shows how far you can take it. I mean, this is just the beginning, but I learned this mostly from film score, because in film score, you think about it, a violin can't play the same notes as a tuba. They're two different like ranges of sound. And so they have to stack up different instruments to play full on chords. Cause let's say the tuba can only play one note at a time in a real orchestra. Then the violin plays another note. Then the, you know, what's another instrument? The flutes play another note. So all three of those things create one chord, but they're across different octaves. And you can learn a lot from film score, but this is how you apply it to modern music without sounding dated or cheesy or anything. Thank you. here's how I applied it to. So if you want some handmade, hand curated sounds, Hermes is for you. We just added two expansions called Dark Trap and Rare. I'll leave a link below for all this stuff. But there's really cool textures to stack up and create chord voicing for. So again, the new music theory course is called Music Theory in Under 10 Minutes. If I have it up by this video, I'll leave the link below. If it's not ready yet, look for the link below eventually. So thanks for watching today. It's Game from BusyWorksBeats.com.